In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up and use two-factor, also called two-step login, for your Bitwarden account. First thing you need to do is to log into your Bitwarden account, then go up to the person icon here, then go to account settings, then go to security, then two-step login. The free Bitwarden accounts have two options for two-step login: the Authenticator app or email. Both are great options no matter what. For most people, email will be just fine. And to turn that on, you click on Manage, enter your master password, then your email address will be there. Press Send Email. They will send you a 6-digit code that you enter here. After you enter the 6-digit code, press Enable, and you'll have email two-step login enabled. Another option is the Authenticator app. You can use Authy, Google Authenticator, Aegis on Android only, or 2FAS, 2FAS on iOS. All great options. Even Microsoft Authenticator app is a great option too. To turn that on, you click on Manage, enter your master password. Then you can download Authy or Microsoft Authenticator. The Bitwarden supplies you links here. I'll take you to the options. Then using the app, you scan the QR code here. After you scan it, it'll generate a 6-digit code that changes every 30 seconds. Enter that 6-digit code here, then press Enable. In this section, I highly recommend writing down this key. This is your secret key. Keep that somewhere safe, like a safe deposit box or somewhere hidden in your home. You can also right-click this QR code here, save image, and save it somewhere in a computer so you can print it out. I suggest you do not save this somewhere in the cloud, this QR code. I suggest printing it out. Then once it's printed out, get rid of the digital copy. You only want this in a physical form for the most security. This QR code does not expire, so you can use it as many times as you want. That QR code just resembles this secret key here. The secret key is inside this QR code. The QR code is just used for it's easier for applications to read it. So save both of these items if you want. It's ideal that you do, just for a backup. Once you've enabled it, you click Enable, and you have enabled the app version of 2FA or two-step login for Bitwarden. The most secure two-step login for Bitwarden and for most accounts online is Web Authn, also called FIDO2 Web Authn, or U2F, some may even call it, but it's technically Web Authn and the FIDO2 standard. But you will require a premium membership to Bitwarden to be able to use it. Well worth it, if you ask me. But once you have the premium membership, to activate it, you go to Manage, enter your master password. And in this section, you can add up to 5 keys. Now, what keys do you need? The keys you have to physically buy. The most popular ones and the ones I recommend are the Yubico YubiKeys. It's the blue key that right here is the one you want. What you want to pay attention to is that it has FIDO2. So you want the ones that are FIDO2. Pretty much all YubiKeys are. You can buy fancier keys that do more, but honestly, the blue and cheaper blue Yubico YubiKeys are all you need. I suggest buying 2 of them though. One will be a backup and one you will keep on you at all times. Once you do that, you plug it into a USB port on your computer. Then you name it. I like to name mine wherever it's located. So this will be on my keychain. Then you press Read Key. Then you get the Windows prompt and from Chrome too. Press OK. It's going to ask you to touch the key So touch the key. Usually they start blinking where you need a touch. And that'll tell you that has read the key. Then you press the save button here to save the key. Then it has saved the key in one of the slots. If you need to start over again, because you got new keys, press disable all keys, then redo the process. Then you have successfully added a security key to your Bitwarden account. You can press close to get out of this window. You know it's added because you have a green check mark right here next to the name. You can actually add multiple two-step options for logging in. So you can also have all of them if you wanted to. You can have the Authenticator app, or you can have email, or you can have the web authn. All options if you want to. Of course, web authn is the strongest. So that is what Bitwarden is going to actually default to. It always defaults to the strongest option that you have when you're logging in from a new device. After you enable two-step login and all the ones you want, the most important thing you should do next, and please do not forget to do this, is to click the Review Recovery Code button, then enter your master password, press Continue, then they'll show you recovery code. Print this out or write it down. Please store this somewhere safe. The best place will be on your emergency sheet, along with your master password that you store somewhere secure in your home. It could be under your mattress, in a safe, safe deposit box, in your sock drawer, wherever you deem safe, but please make sure you write this down. All right, next I'm going to show you how to log in when you have two-step enabled. So what you do is you go to the bitwarden.com website and go to the login area, enter your email address and master password, press the login button, and they're going to default to the most secure option, which I have FIDO2 Web Authn. And it's going to ask me, Microsoft's going to ask me, because Chrome is asking Microsoft to touch the secure key that it's already plugged into my computer. So I'm going to tap that. There's a green blinking light for usually on the YubiKeys. So I'm going to tap that area. Then it logs me in. I'm going to log back out to show you how the other options are there. So we'll log out, enter your master password, we'll log in. Same thing before, I can touch the key to log in. WebAuthn is most secure and most resistant to phishing, but I'm going to press the cancel button. And then I'm going to say, use another two-step login method. And we have multiple options here. We can do the WebAuthn, we can do the email, or you can enter your recovery code. So pressing the select button here, you enter that six-digit code, you can also log in that way.